As we promised, we are going to talk today about the parliamentary elections, the runoff of the parliamentary elections of the first phase, which is taking place in 14 governorates in Egypt today. To shed more light on that very important topic today, we are very much delighted to have our very own dear guest, Dr. Hoda Zarqana, the former member of parliament. Good morning, Dr.
Good
Hoda.
Morning.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Good morning, Dr. Hoda. Well, me and Mahisi, we have a lot of questions for you since you are a former parliamentarian. You are the expert. So we have a lot of questions regarding what has been going on in the past few days, of course, yesterday and last week. But first, we have with us our correspondent from El Haram district, Basmata, to tell us more about the latest developments in the polling stations in El Haram today. Good morning to you, Basma.
Good morning, Hala, to you and your guests. I am now at Hisham Sheta School in Haram. It belongs to Omraniyya constituency. There are 16 constituencies in Giza governorate, and in Omraniyya constituency, there are four candidates competing for two seats. There are 550 election centers in Giza, and there are also 4 million voters and 72 candidates in Giza governorate. In Hisham Sheta School, there are 15,021 voters registered. Let me tell you that the polling station here in Hisham Sheta School opened exactly at 9 a.m. and Egyptians started to head to the voting stations to cast their votes. So far, everything is organized and everything is going smoothly. Judges also started to go to their polling stations to supervise the elections. Yesterday, let me tell you a quick wrap-up. Here in Hisham Sheta's school, Giza Governor Dr. Khalid Zakaria paid a visit to this school, and he called upon all Egyptians to come and cast their votes for the sake of Egypt. He also noted that heavy security measures were taken by the Ministry of Interior as well as Giza Governorate in order to secure the polling stations. As you know, full judicial supervision is taken in order to secure at the polling stations, and Minister of Defense Sid Issoubhi has allocated helicopters to transfer judges to remote areas and villages. Also, heavy security measures are taken in order to protect the voters and the voting stations. Heavy deployment from the security forces are found everywhere in order to provide a safe atmosphere to the voters so they would feel free and secure at the same time. Though we are still in the early morning, but voters started to head to the voting stations, and the coming hours will witness an increase in the number of voters. As you know, today is the second and the last day of the runoff round of the 2015 parliamentary elections.
Yes. Hello? Basma Taha, our correspondent from El Haram district, particularly Hisham Sheta school, where the polling station is there. She said that everything is very smooth. Thank you very much, Basma, for now, but we are waiting more updates from you throughout the day. Thank
and
you.
And back to our dear guest in the studio, Dr. Hoda. Dr. Hoda, how far do you see the process of the parliamentary elections? We have seen, of course, the first part of the first phase of the parliamentary elections taking place. And today we have started the voting process 10 minutes ago because the polling stations are open at 9 a.m. Until 9 p.m. And yesterday the voting process took place as well. So how do you see the process up to this moment, Dr. Hoda, in the first phase of the
elections? I have to say that everything was taken care of regarding the governmental procedures and the security measures and the judges and the committees and all that stuff, and also you're representing your correspondent everywhere, which is very positive sign, and it indicates that there is an alertness and a high responsibility taking place in Egypt, you know, because a lot of people were confused for the last few weeks, and maybe we witnessed more activation in the parties. They went to the people and they showed their faces and said, we are the one you're going to elect, and there is a process in the last week was noticed in the street, especially in the governorate of Giza, because the people were, they have their excuses. They don't know who to select, who to pick up, and they are very suspicious. Maybe this guy is behind, is a coverage for somebody, which we are fear of their presence in the parliament, actually. Yes. And this is what kept some people away or a little bit rather watching than going and having the procedure as they will share. Egyptians share when they feel secured. When they feel secured and the person they know very well, he will be committed to their demands and their needs, I think they should participate and they will participate. That's why we may witness an increase in the number of the voters today.
But there seems to be a problem, Dr. Hoda, as you mentioned. Not everyone knows about the candidates, especially the individual seats candidates. I have been discussing this with my friends and family, and each one gets to ask the other, who are you going to vote for? Because I don't know anyone. Do you suggest, do you have any suggestions? And perhaps here the blame lies on the candidates. Because they should have reached out to the public and used all means of campaigning, especially that nowadays, they, I mean, I haven't seen anyone using social media, for example, as one way. Not enough conferences for them. The public. How do you see that?
Well, I can see that this is a negative attitude. Maybe they feel so much confident that everybody knows them. Some of the candidates in Giza. He got a repetition today, he said, okay, I'm well known. But nobody knows what you did for your area in the previous
round.
So you have to be there, you have to show your face, you have to. That's why some candidates win the run from the first time. They went to these suburbs and they were talking to the people. Yes, please?
But only four candidates did win from the first round, which is it's quite a minimal number, Dr. Hoda.
Yes, I'm telling you. a lot of people feel they are okay, I'm gonna win. I doesn't care, I don't know. Or maybe
over self-confidence?
Or maybe he's also sure that he has the upper hand over the people. They will pick me for sure. Because I am well known, I don't know the situation, but if I'm going to run in the for election, I should do some work. I should do some heavy duty work. And also, that we've been advising, as you can say, that the last week I was, or 2 weeks ago, I was giving this notice that the people should do some work on the streets. And they should be there representing themselves to the people, because they are really a lot of people. Even today, I received calls, can we go again, we'll give our votes first, and we our candidates were, okay, we won. Should we go for the second round? Because nobody gave a notice in the media for that.
So there seems to be a lot of confusion
And that's why I said, okay, go ahead and go give your opinion on the other two. Maybe you share with your votes and... and a positive attitude, which she's a lady over 60. And I admire this responsibility, because we lacking this in the young generation.
Yes, that coming question, Dr. Hoda, because when I sit with many people, middle age or younger generation, they are telling me, why should we go to the polling stations? Why should we vote? Because it won't make a big difference. Things are going smooth now. There are no threats like before. We are not afraid from anything.
No,
like
this
during
is
the time of
this
the brotherhood.
Is the most dangerous point.
So, not only that, but also our correspondents in the polling stations told us that the voters were mainly elderly and women, and there was a very low the youth.
Yes, this is the issue. Maybe they give her the answer right now.
Many are thinking that way, and others are thinking, no, we are not appreciating, or we are not happy with the candidates who are running for the election. So between the two opinions,
go and give a note for these candidates. I'm not in favor of that. But the thing that they are, this young generation is really full of depression. I said, okay, they don't belong to me, I don't know them, maybe they won't do anything for me, maybe they want my voice, and that's it. After that, they will close the doors in front of my face.
So,
a lot of people said so.
But I have to give them the chance, Dr. Hoda, and see if they are good, the trial and error.
Yeah, this is
we
the
have
issue.
To try.
That's what I said to this guy. I told him, you have the upper hand over him, because if he's reluctant and you give him your voice, you go ahead, tell him you don't worth it, and next time you will be down. Because this is the issue of the parliament. It's not Egypt only, it's in the states. Find congressmen, give promises, and they will go behind their candidates are doing
it's
other
elections.
Ads. And this
the
is
election.
It's
the game.
It's the game. Yes. So this is why we won't be surprised. But the thing that we shouldn't be that backward. We should be upfront and have the courage to do and have the decision.
Yes.
If you don't have the decision, you won't be a real man later. Because you have to make a decision.
Yes. Dr. Hoda,
sorry, nobody get angry from me, but this is the truth. This
is
psychological, analysis. If you are not able to have a decision, you are not going to be one of the kind.
Yes.
Let me put it this way.
Maybe the voting process takes place in a different way according to the constituencies or according to the geographic place. For example, if we take Upper Egypt as an example, there seems to be the tribal dominance and tribes dominate everything that's going on.
Yes.
So with the elections taking place in governorates like Bani Suif, Minya, Asyut, Suhail, Qinn, Luxor, and Aswan, how do you see this tribal dominance affecting the elections?
Well, they do. They do, actually, because they have a lot of, you know, power in the streets and the neighbors. Mm-hmm. They are neighbors. They are just neighbors. They go. Everybody will come and support the...
Different from cities like
course,
Alexandria.
Of course,
and
in Giza also,
and in Giza,
not everybody
course.
In Dokia and, you know, Tahrir Square or
yes,
anything.
The whole situation is different.
It's there. Completely different, of course, and the culture itself, it dominates. Also, their ability to communicate with the people, because he's very far. His residence may be in Maadi or in Lafar.
Yes.
Of Giza, and I am in Imbab, and I should give, and he is in my territory, so I have to know him more close. So this is the thing that and pitfalls of this election should be studied very well to make lessons and to give an overview, because we have, from now on, we have to take our part and share and the history of our country and the decision in our country. Nobody will prevent you. And the young, they should know that. That's why it's their chance to say their opinions, because if they are reluctant, they won't share in anything. They will be aside because they don't have decision to make. So I give my advice to everybody next. Please give your voice, share, and be courageous and talk about it. Why you don't have this chance to try yourself, try the candidate. Maybe if he's not the one you are not imagining, so you're going to be facing him later and say to him, your program said so and so. And this is the issue. If any of these candidates give a program to the people, I think they should read it and they should make decision according to the programs of the candidates. But I don't know how far they did, because I belong to Cairo government, I'm not in Giza.
Indeed. Dr. Hoda, since we are talking now about Cairo governorate, I believe that the people in Cairo are much more aware about the candidates of their constituency more than the others, because maybe also in many Delta governorates as well. Because I was sitting with many people and they are exactly aware who they are going to vote for, which coalition, which list, and which individuals who are running for the elections. And I was really impressed. I was so happy to hear that. So do you believe that we are going to witness a change in the attitude, or to witness something different in the second phase of the parliamentary elections?
Yes, and by the end of this day, you will notice a change. Today, why Gael governorate? Because they're always keen about what they're going to... They have a lot of interest in the government, in the business area, in the education area, and a lot of people are there. So they are caring very much about who's going to be in the parliament. If they can communicate with him, if this is an educational problem or environmental or whatever, but in areas, and maybe the people are a little bit absent and they are consumed by their daily demands, maybe. That's why they don't pay attention to the political issue. That's why they need to responsibility for anybody to take it and make the solutions and give them end result solution. On the contrary, in Cairo governorate, you find a hell of educational level and a hell of financial also rise, because they have not that doesn't mean that in Giza there is nothing called capitalism or money-carrying people. No, they have a lot, but they process it in another way. In Cairo, you will find the people of the universities, the people of the government, the people of the high rank of businessmen also.
And the competition more fierce, of
yes,
course.
And they care about who's going to be there to communicate and yes. to run. If we have anything in the investment law, we have anything mm-hmm. in the economical problems.
Yes.
So that's why they care and they participate and they are very cautious about the one who, and they make decisions upon this. Mm-hmm. And the ladies also are very aware. Mm-hmm. And also there is a percentage of Christian in Cairo and Jobra and Heliopolis. And they are very aware and very conscious also. Mm-hmm. So I expect more than 45% in Cairo from the mm-hmm. first round.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What about women in parliament? There have been a lot of efforts to try to encourage women to
I'm very sad for the women.
Yes.
Yes, and it seems sad. I mean, things are really frustrating for women because women have been so active in the political life in Egypt.
Yeah.
Actually, from a historical point of view, I mean, Egyptian women were queens, but if we the recent political developments in Egypt since 2011 until now, women have been very active. They have been there involved in each and every development taking place, and they voiced their concerns. And there seems to be a state of frustration because we have the women, we have good calibers, we have good candidates. What seems to be hindering their way to the parliament?
Well, to tell you the truth, this election especially, we're expecting more work from the Council of the Women Council.
National Council for Women.
Yes, yes. The Council of Women, they should push a lot of candidates. They did in the, various distant parts, in Sinai and El Wadi Gedid, all these areas. But in Cairo and other areas around, I didn't notice that they have...
Unlike the previous elections.
Yeah. It was really surprising for me.
Why?
I don't know. I have no explanation.
It was shocking for me as well, Dr. Hoda, because we expected more participation from women, more active role on the political scene. But we did not see that. I don't know.
They don't have any positive impulses from, I don't mean
do you
think
the parliament. It's a funding problem? Do you think that they needed proper funding?
Maybe this is another point. Funding problem is another point, yes. Mm. They have to be sponsored by someone.
Yes.
And the council, the National Council, will take that place, will take this responsibility. Maybe they have their ways more influential for the government. They give their propaganda free for some areas.
An initiative was launched by... NGOs called Women for Women initiative to support these women.
I don't know how many women they did. I don't know. Did they mention any names? I have no area. I have not.
The problem remains. The problem remains. Women can't be fully represented or even well represented in the parliament.
Yes,
and
because of this issue.
Because
so
this
maybe,
is one of the issues.
Maybe the thing.
And I think one of the other issues is that we don't have this culture or awareness that men would vote for women. I mean, a man wouldn't go and vote for a woman, especially in Upper Egypt or in certain districts that
No. I gave you Nariman and Daramali. She was one of a kind. She was from Beirut, and they gave her the highest votes. And
she was in
Upper Egypt?
Of course. Mm. Yeah. And
because
she was picked among 10 women
exactly.
over the
this
world.
This is a very valid point of view.
Because of the family
name.
Yes, family gave vote. Yes,
and
support.
This is a tribal area.
Yes, it's the tribal effect. Mm, yeah. And they trust women. Don't tell me, Upper Egypt, they don't trust women. No, they respect women. They trust her.
Of course.
And she is the upper hand in the family. No man can give a decision except after her acceptance and approval. Mm. So this is the issue.
In Upper Egypt, women are
very powerful.
And governor, I mean, like Umda, they have a female Umda, yes.
Yes, of course, because this is what we have to, we have to elaborate. And that's why I'm still positive about this election process. Mm. It will continue and will proceed. But the thing that the women feel frustrated, they don't have the support of the government. They don't have the support of the National Council of Women. They don't have even NGOs who claims that they support them. I don't know, they did nothing for them. Okay. So this is the issue that a lot of women, a very respected ranks in Egypt, are backing because they don't want to humiliate themselves, of course. So if they're gonna run, she has to present herself in the media also with a great program. And the media cost a lot, of course. And the program, it should be maybe over the internet issue, and that's Facebook. Maybe she can have provide an idea about her way of thinking, her way of solution solving, her way of presentation. Because you need women in the international level, in the national level, in the urban, and the, you know, and the people in the, I mean, the grassroots of your society, we have to communicate with these people. So this woman is mandatory, should be in the parliament.
Okay. But do you expect to see some changes in the second phase of the parliamentary elections regarding the participation of women, both as candidates and, of course, as voters?
I feel that you are frustrated yourself because you are asking the way you don't feel that you, you get results.
It's quite disappointing. It's quite disappointing to see, because during the past parliamentary elections, we have seen real participation for women, even if they did not make it, or some of them did and some they didn't. And I believe you, as a former member of parliament, you witnessed that there was somehow kind of for women, which we are not actually seeing right now.
Well, a lot of women I know, they were trying to be in this parliament, but unfortunately,
because of the funding issue, or because
the
of
funding, the process, the repetition of the exams, and repetition of maybe somebody were abroad for a while, and he showed that his paper in the court, and that's it, he will be there. And they found out that somebody changing, you have to repeat so and so and so. This process were hindering a lot of women and put obstacles because they didn't catch the time of the even the medical checkup again. Why medical checkup again for the woman? Why? They don't actually, we don't have addicts in women. Rate of addiction in women are very, very, very nothing. And I was talking to one of the the highest election committee about this issue, and this is not right to repeat a medical checkup, and because they did it from the first time and it was very clear. So all, you know, cream of the creams, there's a lot of women bright and intelligent and quite specialized financially and politically, even, and former parliamentarians also fair to join this election because of this process.
Routine.
And we are depriving ourselves from the good quality of women, actually, and they are very, very much needed in this parliament.
That is very
because we are facing still the currents of darkness behind the scene.
They maybe are there is a solution to that, Dr. Hoda, but perhaps we can discuss it further. Let's take a short break first, and we'll be right back. Stay with us.